guys, it is me, Life Simmer, and welcome back to The Sims 3 Into the Future, Part 24. Okay, so in this part, little Miss Lily is going to be getting married to Noel. And also, it's Indigo's birthday, or Violet's, not Indigo, Violet's birthday, so we're going to go ahead and get her aged up. And also, I added in one residential family and two community lots that I kind of just randomly made. They're really not that good. I kind of just threw them in there just so we could do something. So the wedding lot, this is not the wedding lot, but I'll show you guys that in a second. Right here is just a little restaurant slash vending, fruit and veggie vending site type of thing. It's called the Little Slice of Italy, and it is pretty much, you can't really tell how it really looks right now because of all the snow, but we're definitely gonna come here in spring and everything and come here and get some pizza and some food, and also come out here and sell some veggies and buy some, and, you know, some lemonade and all that good stuff. Looks a lot cuter with all the, snow gone, but there's that. And then we will also be getting married right here. This is like the crappiest wedding lot ever. It is really just to simply get married. So, you know, just has the wedding arch and all that good stuff. And yeah, it also looks a lot cuter without the snow, but it will do. And then I also added in some friends. Yes, I added in some friends. Where are they? Here they are. No, that's not them either. Where are they? Oh, right here, the Fortin family. Pretty much, I wanted Indigo to make some friends, so I did. She is now friends with a pair of twins. I was like, oh, would that be a pair of twins, or would it just be twins? She came friends with some twins. Their name is Fiona Fortin and also Ariel Fortin, and she's also friends with Star Shu. I went ahead and had her come over here, you know, make some friends and everything, and, yeah, they live right here in this little cottage. And I think Brandy is friends with Bethany Fortin. And Cody is friends with nobody. Cute. So, yeah. They're just like a quaint little family. They, pretty much their backstory is there is, you know, a married couple. They adopted twins. And now they are raising two twin teenage daughters, which I can only imagine how hard that is. So yeah, that's pretty much how that goes. So I also changed up Lily's appearance. I know this is the longest intro ever. I also changed up Lily's appearance a little bit, just her outfits, because she is going to be getting pregnant. And I have a, I don't know if this would be a mod, but morph, a pregnancy morph thing that makes me be able to use outfits from certain expansion packs, stuff packs, base game content, and store stuff that she can actually wear while she's pregnant. So this is going to be her pregnancy outfit. I know it's not very winter-like, but this is what she's going to have her little pregnant belly in, and all the outfits that you see, they're all pregnancy compatible, I'm pretty sure. So yeah, she's, you know, just gonna be rocking the belly in some cute little outfits instead of the ugly maternity wear that I'm so sick of using. So yeah, today is actually a snow day. Woo. So I think we're going to go ahead and invite over our new friends and Star Shu. We can have a little girls' day, maybe have a sleepover this weekend. I think that'd be kind of fun. You're not going to school. You're not going to school. Ooh, free vacation. Leave the teens alone. They're surely responsible enough to take care of the house while you're away. Sorry, there's too much going on right now to actually do that. Sure, I'll come over in a little while. All right. So, they should all come over. It's a snow day, technically, so... Oh, did they get rid of the snow day? Ooh. Ooh. Well, it all depends on if our friends actually come, if we're actually going to go to school. I really don't want to go. I don't think our friends are going to come. Yeah, all right. We're going to go ahead and head to school. Yesterday, I did do one day off camera, and it was a snow day, and it was, like, a lot of fun. So, I guess we're going to go to school a little late, so that's good. But she's going to go and talk to her friends. Okay, and then this afternoon, we are going to go ahead and have the wedding. But right now, we're going to go try for a baby. She won't have her pregnancy belly this evening, so that will work out perfectly. So let's go try for babies. He's coming in there with his jetpack, ready to dive in. Oh, and he tripped. Cute. All right. I didn't hear it. Do it again. Oh, Cosma actually just did a really cool upgrade. She upgraded the computer to have better graphics, which I thought was pretty awesome. yeah. So let's see if the graphics actually look better. Let's play a skating game. And see if the graphics look any different. From what I can tell, they really don't, but, you know, I'm a computer geek. If my Sims think they have a better graphics card, then so be it. So, let's set the intensity to this, to 5. Alright. Come on, you two. Alright, and there it is. She's now pregnant. Which is very exciting. We're going to go ahead and throw Violet's little, not really a birthday party, but just go ahead and have her age up right now. Even though her sister is at school, that's totally okay. Put that back. All right, it's totally okay, guys. It's totally A-okay. So, yeah, we're going to go ahead and age her up. Let's go ahead and do that. Blow out candles, Violet Freeman. She is our adopted baby. And Cosmo's gonna bring it to the cake. Cosmo's so cute. Alright. Go away. Alright. Cody's on his way home. Lovely. That's who else wasn't here. Okay, let's go ahead and take a look at little Miss Violet. She's cross-eyed and adorable. She's really cute. All right, what is this moodlet? Forced shutdown. Utterly depleted batteries forced Cosma into temporary shutdown. She'll need to take some time to recover. So Cosma, right now, is just in shutdown. And we can't move her either. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Alright, Noel, why don't you come here and feed her on the floor? Or actually, Cody's doing it. Aw, Cody, you're such a good dad. Alright, so yeah. She's gonna eat her foods. And, yeah. Alright. No, actually, Lily, go ahead and throw a party. Come on, guys. Alright. Oh, look at the pretty little rainbow. Leading right to our wedding spot, which I actually need to make a switch this really quick. Let me edit town, just continue. Alright, let's make this right here. Edit this. Community lot. Visitors allowed. Look, the rainbow is like right directly above our wedding venue. So I think that means something, you guys. I think that means it's supposed to happen. Alright, why can I still not click it? Oh, let me do this really quick off camera and switch the settings really quick so we don't have to do it again. Alrighty, guys, so there we go. For exclusive access, it is 320 simoleons. We are going to throw a wedding party. It will begin at, 6 p.m. is a pretty good time. Formal attire, of course, and let's go ahead and bring friends and everything. We are going to invite the new Fortins so you guys can see them. Noel's daughters, of course, and Star Shu. Let's see who else. Who do we work with? We'll invite our co-workers. And that's it. That's all we need. Okay. We need to actually head over there, but first, before we leave, let's go ahead and get a wedding cake. Okay, put that in our inventory. Let's head on out. Go, not to Slice of Italy. I don't want Slice of Italy. Visit Small Park with Brandy, Cody, Cosma, Noel, and even Violet. Alrighty, guys, it is time to get married and time to do the big deed of getting married. Yeah, that's what I meant. But yeah. This place is, like I said, it's really nothing special. Like, I didn't even put pictures up or anything. It's simply just to get married. Yeah, they should all be here very shortly. Yep, here they are. Alright, Cosma. Oh, she's in such a bad mood. And I don't think there's anything here that she can even siphon from. Actually, I think she can do it from here. Nope, she can't. Oh, no. Alright, so people are starting to show up, but I'm gonna have Lily go ahead and head inside now. Alshay gives her wedding dress. It's pretty cute. So this is Lily's wedding dress right here. It is from, what is it from? I think it's from the homecoming attire set. And I just customized it a little bit. It's really, really adorable. She's a beautiful bride, as you. She's always beautiful. But yeah. I'm gonna have them start the wedding pretty soon. Not too soon, but around 6:20. Yeah. Let's go ahead and put the wedding cake out. Alright, there's the wedding cake. Playing her Rhythmicon right here, right now. She's funny. Alright. No. I'm gonna try to have everybody kind of just sit down right now. Get a little organized. Look, my chairs aren't even in here. That just tells you how much time I put into this, right? Yeah, everybody's just gonna kind of relax. People are beginning to arrive, which means the wedding is going to start very shortly. Alright. Yes. Alright, so let me go ahead and show you guys the Fortins really quick. Here is Ariel Fortin right here. And then right over here is Fiona Fortin. She's more of the rebellious, you know, I don't know what she's wearing, but I don't know what any of them are wearing. Their everyday outfits are pretty cute, but she's more of the rebellious, like, I really don't care. And then here's her sister, Ariel Fortin, which is kind of cute because they're both matching. And then here is Tisha Freeman, like I said, don't know what they're wearing. This is one of Noel's daughters, and then where's his other daughter? His other daughter should be around here somewhere. I mean, for goodness sake, her dad is getting married. She needs to be here. But yeah, we're gonna go ahead and get married now. The guests should all be here for the most part. Here's Bethany Fortin arriving. This is one of their new friends. Oh, and she's leaving. Okay, whatever. This werewolf needs to go somewhere. Lily, you know what? Before we get married, whack his nose. Get married. Whack his nose before you get married. Do not even dare boo Cosma, because I will knock you out, bitch. I will knock you out. Alright, it's time to get married, guys. Tisha Freeman's throwing a party. What a little beach. Oh my goodness. Cosma, it is not time for that. Cosma, no, it is not time to teach Violet how to walk. Everybody get inside. Stop building snowmen. Get inside. Well, no. Thanks for putting a lot of effort into your outfit. I really appreciate it. Lily's like, this is all I ever wanted. Is everybody ready, or are you all going to be rude? They're all going to be rude. They're all so rude. It's unbearable. All right, awesome. So they are now married. Now everybody's awing and saying how cute it is. Lovely, lovely, lovely. Yep, now we're gonna go ahead and come over here and cut the cake. Awesome. They are now married. So yeah, they're gonna go cut the wedding cake together so people can begin eating it. And yeah, this is quite a large party of people for such a small room. Half of these people I didn't even invite. Like, here's some waiters here for the food right here. They're waiters, which is pretty cool, I guess. Cody, stop it. He's like, I don't want any of your cake anyways. And walks away with, what are those? Firecracker shrimp. Come on, you two, cut the cake. All right. There's the wedding cake, and now she's getting nauseous for unknown reasons. I wonder why. Yeah, but everybody's just gonna come here and hopefully grab a slice. Everybody's being so annoying right now. And then there's like little Violet being so innocent and just sitting here doing her thing while everybody else is over here doing this. Being like scavengers and peasants over food. What is up with all the teenagers wearing the same skirt? Is that like what's in right now? And there's Indigo wearing her little sexy little number. Oh, the entertainment of the night is Lily Freeman on her Rhythmicon. How cute is she? Alright, and Cosma's practically dead here in the middle. When Cosma wakes up, I'm gonna have her head home. She's really, really in bad shape right now. She really is. Alright, let's get turned up, as they would say. Apparently, we don't have a bartender. What the hell? What the hell? So everybody's gonna have a good slice of cake and kind of just relax a little bit. The main part of the night's over, so that's good. All right, here is the bartender. We're gonna go order a pomegranate passion. That sounds pretty yummy. Order a pomegranate passion and yeah. And Noel will come over here and order a pink bunny. A little pink bunny. So yeah. One of Noel's kids actually did not show up, which is ridiculous considering this is her father. Yeah. They didn't show up. This one right here. Marina Freeman. She did not show up. What a little turd. Uh-oh, she's throwing up. On her wedding day. Little does she know. I guess if she's pregnant, I really shouldn't be having her, drink some drinks. But she doesn't know right now, so she's gonna go get a drink of alien brain. Everybody's just gonna have some drinks and everything. We have an open tab, which means they can drink as much as they want, and we'll pay for it. Which is actually horrible. But, whatever. All right, cool. Nobody got their drink, but okay, cool. It's real cool. All right, I actually think Noel has the new phone that came with the future. Yeah, his holophone. It's cool. Lily's just all about her Rhythmicon tonight. Tisha Freeman's party starting soon. He better not want to miss it. Noel is going to miss your party because your sister did not show up. That is so rude of you. You have no idea. You should have brought your freaking sister. And now you're going to touch the baby? Oh, no. Stop it. Don't touch the baby. Don't kiss our baby. Stop. Do not kiss my baby. All right, she's leaving. Whatever. Everybody's just kind of jamming out. This is exactly what we're going to do when we're level 10. All right, Cosma, go ahead and head home before you, like, die. Fall apart. Get the blue screen of death. This is Lily's dream right here. Everybody's just like, mm-hmm. They're doing, like, the little head bob. The little duck face head bob that is, like, known for The Sims 3. I remember seeing that in the Sims 3 trailer and, like, being like, that is so cute. Lily's getting it, too. Alright, people are beginning to leave, saying, oh, this is a pretty good party. That's good. It's a little crazy for a while, but this is good. Very, very good. Alright, she's getting tired. So we're gonna go ahead and have everybody head home now. Like, Indigo's already home and in bed. Alrighty, guys. So yes, like I was saying, everybody's gonna head to bed and just get some sleep. It's been a long night, you know what I mean? So everybody's gonna head home, get some sleep, and now Noel and Lily are finally married and pregnant, which is very exciting. Oh, you guys are probably thinking, why is she wearing like a little schoolgirl outfit? Long story short, it's for her pregnancy. So, yeah. Look, guys, it's a hooker. Aww. Alright, yeah. Everybody's heading home now. And, was there, like, a taxi accident back here? Oh, there was a taxi accident back here. Oh, weird stuff like that. I love that. I love weird stuff like that that just you randomly see in your game. I love that so much. But yeah, I will see you guys in the morning. Alrighty, so it is now morning, and we're gonna go ahead and wait and see Lily's little pregnancy occurrence, I guess. See her, you know, get declared pregnant. And I think we're also going to throw a little sleepover tonight, but then at the same time, I want to throw a feast party on Snow Day, but at the same time, I don't. I kind of just want to have, like, a family feast together. So I'm thinking, you know, because tomorrow is Snow Day, that we could throw a sleepover, even though we really don't have room for one. We could throw a little sleepover. I think that'd be kind of cool. You know, invite all the girls over. Or we could just say, you know, throw a little party for her. Or we could just, you know, not. But she actually seen or met this kid named Davy Cho. He looks pretty cute right here. We're going to go ahead and talk to our friends. And maybe we can get to know him a little bit more. Seems like a cutie. So yeah. No, why are you screaming like a banshee? Lead field trip at the science facility this weekend. Cody Freeman. Oh, sure. We will definitely do that. He actually should be getting a promotion today, and he should be now education level 3, even though he's in a terrible mood because he did not get any sleep last night because of his crazy partying. oh, well. But yeah, Lily should be getting her pregnancy belly any second now. Here she goes. I mean, you won't be able to really tell, but she's pregnant now, you guys. And she wants a baby boy. Aww. I can't wait to see her belly get bigger. That's what I'm excited for. I just want to see Lily with a cute little belly. So let's go ahead and announce our pregnancy to Noel. See what he has to say about it. What do you think, Noel? We should have tried for a baby with a jetpack. Oh, well. He's like, oh, really? Oh, I would have never guessed. Only one day after a wedding and my girlfriend, or actually my wife now, is already pregnant. How special. All right, we're going to go ahead and hold his hands, and we're going to kiss him. And we're going to be frisky, which actually is just another woohoo interaction. Your Sims will be frisky. Yeah, let's go ahead and be frisky. Why not? Yeah, now they're going to go woohoo. Cody has left work today. Awesome. Now he is a substitute teacher. He got a bonus of 288 simoleons. Got the flu? Not you. He now makes 29 simoleons per an hour and works from 8 a.m. to 2 p.m. Awesome. So, Cosma, how are you doing, girl? She's okay. She's always wanting to cook food. Always wanting to. Just go relax. Go recharge yourself, Cosma. You are a busy little bumblebee, always. She actually, just made a snowman back here, which we will actually bring it up front. Our snowmen out here are starting to melt, and it looks really depressing. So, go ahead and snow that one. We're going to sell that one, and then we'll have to make another one. Because I don't want my snowmen melting. Indigo, when she gets home, I'll have her do that. But she's actually at debate club right now. The dance is at 6 p.m. What? What dance? The dance is at 6 p.m. Better hurry up and get ready. You need to plan your outfit for the night ahead. Well, her outfit's already ready, but she can't even leave debate club. And she smells like asshole. All right, she's going to have to come home really, really quickly. Take a shower and then head to the dance. Oh, my goodness. Which, I mean, it's okay if she doesn't have a prom date, actually, to be completely honest, considering she has a bunch of awesome new friends. Ooh. She needs to go home right now. See, she definitely wants to throw a little slumber party. Aw. We definitely will. We'll throw one after prom. I think that'd be kind of fun. I don't know, because prom gets out at 10 p.m., so, yeah, we're going to do that. First, she needs to shower, and then we're going to throw a little slumber party tonight. And we'll even invite that David Cho guy. Alright. Some Vada friends. Ariel. Fiona. First, we're going to make it a slumber party. And Star. And let's also invite that David Cho guy. And, of course, pajamas. And we'll begin at 11 p.m. All right, it has to be 10 p.m. All right, as soon as the dance ends, the slumber party will start at 10 p.m. Awesome. So right after prom, we are going to head home and have a little slumber party, so that's good. Hopefully she does get at prom. So yeah, go ahead and change into your formal wear, and then the limo should be here to get you. Let's see. Alright. Thought you said prom was today. Why isn't the limo here? It's 6 p.m. We should be at prom. What's up? What's up? What? Go to prom. Why didn't the limo come get us? What, because we don't have a date? Are you kidding me? Oh. She's gonna take a taxi instead of a freaking limo. Whatever. Alrighty. We're rolling in like a big shot. Not really. We're like an hour late. When is the dance gonna end? Well, we're leaving at 10. Either way, probably a little bit before 10. Oh. Indigo was deemed prom queen. She thanked everyone and started talking about how she really, what she really wants is world peace. Awesome. Good, good, good. Alrighty, so she's probably going to leave at 9:30-ish, so she can head home and, you know, get the sleeping bags and everything settled. They're probably going to end up sleeping, like, in the hallway and in random nooks and crannies of the house, but that's totally whatever and totally okay. Oh, no. Indigo saw someone else wearing the same dress. While they probably were wearing the same dress, there's not enough teen content produced for The Sims 3, so I wouldn't be surprised, to be completely honest. but yeah, I'm going to have all the adults go ahead and already go to bed and everything. Kind of let the teenagers do their thing tonight. Like a little Violet. She's so cute. All right, Cosma, put Violet in her crib. Is she good for the night? She should be. All right, put her in her little cribby, and then Noel, where are you? Noel, go use the toilet. Oh, Indigo was denied for a dance. Whoopsie. Alright. Alright, Indigo, head home now. It says, Indigo steeled her nerves and asked that attractive sim for a dance. She almost cried when she got rejected. Aww. Cosma, I said put Violet to bed. Everybody's going to bed. They're going to let the teens do their things tonight. You know what I mean? Leave them alone. So, no, that includes you. I don't care what you smell like. I don't care. Go to bed. Alright. The school dance has ended, so it might be a good idea to head home before your curfew. Definitely is a good idea. Hopefully some teenagers, her little friends, come. I'll be real mad if they don't. Okay, it's 10:20. None of them are here. Probably wasn't the best idea. You'd think they'd have enough respect to show up. Oh. Oh, nope. Oh, out of everyone, Davy Cho showed up. Davy, the first guest. Oh, here is everybody. Oh, I thought they were all not going to come. Oh, this is exciting. Oh, it's already late, so they're all going to sleep. It's already late, so they're just like, yeah, let's all just pass out. It's not even, like, party. It's just sleep. So, yeah, everybody's just going to sleep, I guess, in their little sleeping bags. You weren't invited. Who are you? You weren't invited. Lily, really? You're about to bust their party? Go to sleep. A bunch of these people weren't even invited. Why are they showing here? Is this like the prom after party? I think it is. Okay, so yeah, I think all the teens are going to go to bed. Oh, that's alright. We're going to definitely throw more slumber parties. Girl, what are you wearing? She wants to be mean to Carlota. You call that a party? Whatever. I'm leaving. Whatever, Star. Call that a party? I'm leaving. I gotta go. That party was dot dot dot. Nice. Oh, you guys are jerks. You too, Carlota. You are our next victim. You are the next Tori. Ooh. Time for bed. That's what slumber parties are all about. Not at all. This is like, I wanted this to be the teen after party. Damn it. Danny Chu, he was not invited, but he sleeps with his eyes open. How scary. Very scary. Well, guys, it's all good. It is okay. Whatever. The teens are here. Well, the twins are here, and they're here to have a good time, right? They're gonna do homework. And watch Indigo's mom embarrass her. That is pretty embarrassing. Let's wake up. Alrighty, so I'm gonna go ahead and have her, I guess, do her homework as well with them. Actually, they can all do it together. I think that'd be cute. Yeah, do homework with Ariel. Alrighty, guys. I'm gonna go ahead and end this part here. I will see you guys in the next part where most likely little Lily will have her babies. And we're gonna go ahead and start talking to that Danny Chu, see what he's all about. So yeah, I love you guys so much, and I will see you guys next time. Bye, guys.